Yeah, now we do have some replays. This is one of the first fights we saw in the game. This was Solofide actually chasing down the squad, and I love this. There was nowhere else for them to run, and so they just corral them into the caravan here and just meticulously pick them apart, team firing after team firing, knocking one, two, and then three to go down there. But yeah, we saw these two early fights coming out from Solofide, and those were the only kills that they ended up getting in this round. It looked like once they got into center position, they just weren't able to do as much. Not as much as THT were able to do on the edge.
We saw so many clean shots throughout this too, and very smart playmaking almost across the board. I don't think we saw any major mistakes. Everybody played fairly clean, but one thing was for sure is the teams that came in confident, the teams that came in aggressive, completely mopped up, and the Mastiff was just so powerful throughout this. Almost every single player that we saw was rocking something or other Prowler or the Mastiff, sometimes both here you see from Teen, and it's the most ideal combo, really, if you're rocking that R301. We don't see many wingmans anymore, Jamerson, unfortunately. A lot of people rocking an auto gun with a shotgun helps when you end up missing a little bit shots. If you have really good tracking, it makes things just a little bit easier, and also it's better on your teammates too, because you are always laying down consistent damage. But here was the jump shot starting things off for Pride. It's just, what happened after this? You don't know. He comes and takes a long angle. Next thing you know, his teammates are going the long way and everybody's already healing. So it's difficult now because you had the high ground. Next thing you know, you're giving up the high ground and coming down low, and you don't see any missed shots there with the Mastiff coming in from Tempest. So THT winning this last team fight and securing themselves a larger lead. Like you said, Jamerson, I think you said 14 points overall. So could have been a 6-point swing for either team if they ended up winning that one.
Yeah, it looked like a great call from THT, right? We saw the bubble coming out from Muffins, and you have to understand THC sees it, only sees two characters inside. Well, where's the Wraith? And so they go ahead and check the sides, check the flank. That's where he is. Take him out and then pick him apart one by one. URW, they had some great pushes, and this is one of them. Inspiring Moose hit some great massive shots, and of course, throwing out this nade ultimately, just kind of forcing them out of positions for them to just wide peek on over. That 76 coming up from the nade, charging up.
Here comes the moonwalk.
That was just beautiful.
There it is. Yeah, and it was that 112 there onto Pathfinder. Low profile Girth just taking pellets to the face. As take a look at Zeratricky winning a team fight inside the train station area. They, again, they are such a strong team fighting team, and it really plays into their composition with the Bloodhound and the Gibraltar. But this was URW in a very surprising fashion coming through here, not only winning this team fight, but fending off the third party from You Like That Mate, the previous game's winner. And when we're looking at teams trying to make a name for themselves, maybe it's Inspiring Moose and URW today that can continue to have a good showing because of the fact that they were able to hold off this really skilled team coming into the situation. I got to give them props. That's not an easy thing to do.
Yeah, one thing we have to remember is that this was not a normal game. By any stretch of the imagination, was this a normal game? We were talking about it looked like ranked, especially with the timings. Half the lobby was dead, essentially, by the time the first ring ended. And so that changes how you have to approach these mid-game fights. You can't approach them the same way that you would if the lobby was still healthy. And so I think a lot of teams still kind of need that experience, which is why you play in these tournaments.
Yeah, typically the game is ending on the next zone here, but since so many people died early, it opens you up on the map and it forces teams to play a little bit more cautious, like you were saying, but you're also going to hop on these type of instances here like Solofide did when you're like, whoa, only three teams left? What, we have the high ground? They're fighting directly below us? This is the perfect scenario and the perfect gun and scope to do so. So you see the bubble come down and the shots landing for Pride. That portal was just bouncing back and forth. They had eyes on exactly where that was going to go. And you could see the pre-fired, choked up Peacekeeper there with the digi threat was just so clean. There's nothing that you can do about it. But again, Inspiring Moose, URW, fantastic job. They held their own against some of the best teams here. I really want to see what their storyline develops as we go forward and kind of keep track of just Inspiring Moose in general, because it's very rare that you have a new name pop up as the kill leader. And, you know, you got to give them credit where it's due, Jamerson, really.
Yeah, definitely here. And so we're seeing just a lot of talent really trying to make a name for themselves. And I'm so glad. This was THT. You know, they had a solid game plan, it looked like. They were playing aggressively, but they were also very controlled, right? They knew when to call for the retreat, go for the reset, not overextend until Petty Boss's squad showed up, until Team Frog showed up there. This was... basically, the game, this is the play that won. There are two plays that won them this game for them. So it started off here. I'm Sung with that lurk that you were talking about, not hitting that Q, not giving away his information and having that flank. This clutched up the fight for them and they were able to survive and ultimately make it into the late game.
Bowser does his best on the Gibraltar, laying down some serious damage, but does get picked off as he tries to drop down. And you're right, it was two game-winning plays from the I'm Sung squad, and did we make it? It was that flank right there, and then it was just the cohesiveness over towards the end, able to put together just an impossible charge and make it work. But this was Team Zeratricky, where we thought they were gonna start to steamroll this lobby based on the way that they were shooting and holding off two really solid teams on both ends of the choke. But they ended up being the team that got held out because they were so late to rotate, and it was by the Rack and Ishu Picket squad. So again, when we go and look at this team fight that happened over towards the Godhouse, we didn't know that it was a separate team over here, 165, that was locking down and sharing the house. The problem with this for 165 is it looks like they just didn't have enough presence inside the window, on the roof, etc. You don't want to let people just kind of infiltrate your building for free. Once they start approaching any type of distance, medium, long range, close range especially, you want to try to back these guys off and push them into somebody else so you can get the kills from the safe position. But
We were talking in the last match, right? I'm Sung and did we make it, having clutch moments after clutch moments. This was also another one of those games where it was clutch moments after clutch moments. Hill with some great massive shots here, closing it all out, getting this knock as he falls back, really allows him to reset for this fight for the eventual third party, and then followed up by Teenage making this call out. Well, I don't know who made the call. I'm just gonna say it was the Wraith, because he portals up for it to gain control of this building, where ultimately this game ends. And so it was just a lot of great decisions, great clutch moments coming out from every member of THT here in game number 5 to close it all out.
Yeah, and this is the crouching tiger, failing dragon strategy over here by You Like That Mate, as they tried to make their way over towards the building. And I don't think I've ever seen that one before in Apex, all three players kind of just making their way over there. And that was the portal play by, again, Hill and THT. Those guys had to take that spot, Jamerson. There's no way you want to sit over here and have to deal with all this action like Solofide had to deal with. And when you go and make a play like that, it's extremely risky, but the reward is very high. And that's what we saw happen from THT. They understand the scenario. They can't play it super safe anymore, just like they did over towards Sorting Factory. It's time for them to make the plays. There's a reason they're sitting in the number one spot. It's because they've been executing on a high level. Let's go ahead and do those plays. Let's make those game-winning decisions and see how it pays off. Ended off paying huge dividends, and now they qualify for Series E.
Yeah, massive, massive plays coming out for them. Again, like we said, stumbled a little bit there. Game number 3, game number 4. Not the best for them, but starting off really strong, continuing to hold that lead, getting a smattering points here or there. We also have to give a shout out, of course, to TSS and RKN's team, right? They put on a show. They put on a show for us indeed.
Flow Rida.
It was typically a slower part of the game. But yeah, coming right back around full circle once again, taking a look at the highlights from game number 5. It was THT to win it all out. And what a great way to do it.
It's so important that Hill wins this fight. Otherwise, THT may not even win this thing this week. The fact that, again, he hits this fadeaway right here, right at the perfect time. And you see Team go in and take so much damage. They both escape with only a sliver of health. And it's such a difficult building to infiltrate because of the fact that you can get third-partied so fast. It was Solofide waiting in the gates to go and get that one. Not only that, they had to deal with adversity where they had to make this portal play. They had multiple teams come and charge their building over towards the outside. They still executed it. And what a way to go, right? Not getting second or third place to secure your way into Series E. Coming out on a dub. Just the way you started this thing has to feel good. And there it is, 77 points. But the big game by Frog will put them in second as well.